All right, let's get into this one. Just had to pick the battery that was half charged. Okay, swap them out to see. Well, they're pretty tight. Now they always say you should disconnect your battery, but this thing's been dead for months now. Fit it in there, otherwise I'll just get my ratchet. Now, as you can tell by the oil and stuff on my hand here, there's this power steering pump has been leaking, and I installed, it's right there, I installed a brand new hose lines when I redid the rack before, I don't know how long ago it was. Anyways, sometime last year, 2 years ago. Actually, reclocked it right here in the driveway. This is all four on the top now. Doody doody doody. And then we'll get to the bottom. 1, 2. And it's just 2. A little different grip on things here. I love these Milwaukee tools, but it's not always the right tool for the job. See, if I got under this thing and much more involved, I got a skid plate underneath here from after the bear encounter. I wasn't willing to run another risk like that. Greasy down here. All right. So they all got different lengths here. Just jimmy this off. Is it missing something? Yeah. It's another one. There's a lot of things in aircraft that, especially body panels, fairings, there's specific screw lengths, and you have to do, you have to make a map for them. So you're out on a piece of cardboard and pop them in that. Otherwise, you got to go back to the manual and figure it all out. It's gonna be a pain in the ass. Okay. Nope, missed one. something different. Fuck, that pump is stupid. Okay, that's annoying. It's a different size, and you need 12. Well, you need 12. Mondays. I figured they'd throw a curveball in here somewhere. Yeah. Of course they did. I undid the power steering bolt. Tighten about 45 inch pounds by hand, if I remember correctly. Ce sont très ennuyeuses. You know, I should have done that in the first place, but what do I care? It's not like I do timing jobs all the time. This is just on YouTube for my embarrassment and your enjoyment. Okay. Actually, I'm doing it by hand right now because of the clearance on the AVCS. Now, the AVCS is an oil-driven system, as you may or may not know. It's hydraulic. Okay. Just dropped inside. That's interesting. Okay. There is no timing guide. That is not how I wanted to find that. Is not at all how I wanted to find that. My word with the engine builder after this. All right. Anyways, so now I can slide the timing belt out with ease, just like that. I don't think you can see it from here. Yeah, everything falls apart eventually. But as you can see, so bolt there, there was no guide, and that needs to be there. Absolutely. This here is the position sensor, and there's nothing contaminating the inside, thankfully, with the oil. So I'll get the cracking off these the idler pulleys, and then we'll call it a break for a minute. I'll clean some stuff up, including myself here. These pulleys are in good shape, but except for that one, it's got jiggle in it. That's not good. So I bet you it cut somewhere in order for this to happen, you know, considering the evidence. That is such an odd failure. And the overall belt is, yeah. What a mess. Fish for that belt or that bolt, wherever it went. Thankfully, it's not inside here, it'll be underneath. Okay. So what's that, a 12? I put it back. Fourteen it is. That's 12. That's not going to do it. I'm gonna get the breaker bar. Doing, Zoe? Or rather, I Sweet. Just take these off by hand now. I'll put them back in the place where I found them for the time being. I can hear the bearings inside, so you know it's a bit shaky. Washer, the skid plate. I got lots of time right now, so I'm not in a rush. And there's only so much time I want to be bent over a car right now. GMB bearing. The ones I'm going to be putting in, the RCM has NTN bearings, which are primo. GMB. I gotta look this up and see where they come from. Be interesting to find that out. I think that's it for now, until I get into doing the compression test. That's going to take some while to get the plugs out, so I'm not going to bore you with that, and I want to save some space on the phone there. I could probably use some brake cleaner in here. It's pretty oily from this leaking sensor up here. Yeah, been like that for a while. But you know, sometimes it's better just to leave something the way it is and to pull it all apart. This is it's been reliable, very reliable till this point. So we're at about 50 or 60,000 kilometers on this motor since it was rebuilt. Anyway, yeah, that's it.